Hello friends, welcome to this video on the number system. In this session, we will learn about different types of numbers and learn about rational and irrational numbers. We have studied numbers and their different types in our previous classes. Let's take some time and revise them once again. Let's start with natural numbers. These are the numbers that come to mind as soon as the term number is mentioned, such as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. We refer to it with the symbol N. Now, if we add the number 0, this series will be called whole numbers, which are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. These are indicated by the symbol W. If we take negative forms of natural numbers, that is, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, etc., so even that group will look something like this. The group formed is called integers and is expressed with the symbol Z. Did it not occur to you as to why do we express integers with symbol Z and not with I? Z is derived from the German word Zahlen, which means to count, and Zahl, which means number. We have seen how these numbers are represented on the number line. Now we will talk about rational numbers. Rational number is the one we represent in the form P by Q, where both P and Q are integers and Q is not zero. We refer to it with the symbol Q, which is derived from the English word quotient. But why quotient, friends? Because P by Q is a fraction that gives us the quotient. Friends, if we pay attention to the definition, why is it said that Q should not be zero? And can we call all the numbers seen so far as rational numbers? Yes, we can represent all these numbers in the form P by Q, such as 30 is equal to 30 by 1. Minus 5 is equal to minus 5 by 1. Here the numerator P and the denominator Q are both integers. That is, all these numbers are rational numbers. Friends, can you tell me, where will all these different numbers, 3 by 2, 24 by 16, 15 by 10, 30 by 20, be placed on the number line? Even though these numbers are different, their value remains 3 by 2, which will be located here on the number line. That is, we can say that rational numbers do not have a unique representation in the form P by Q. And so when we represent P by Q on the number line, we assume that Q is not equal to 0 and P and Q have no common factor other than 1. That is, P and Q are co-prime numbers. Are there any other numbers left? Are there any numbers that we cannot represent as rational numbers? Yes, there are countless numbers which we cannot write as rational numbers, such as root 2, cube root of 3, cube root of 5, root 3, pi, root 15, etc. And we call such numbers as irrational numbers. We represent them with the symbol Q dash. Friends, are you thinking that the square root and cube root of all numbers are irrational numbers? No. Just like root 4, which is 2, and 2 is a rational number. Therefore, root 4 is a rational number. In the same way, root 9, root 16, root 25 are rational numbers. And now speaking of cube root of 8 is 2, which is a rational number. Therefore, cube root of 8 is a rational number. Similarly, cube root of 27, cube root of 64 and cube root of 125 are rational numbers. Numbers that are perfect square roots or perfect cube roots are called rational numbers. And numbers that do not have proper or perfect square root, cube root, etc. are called irrational numbers. Irrational numbers were first detected by Greek Pythagorean Hippasus of Croton, who said that these are numbers that cannot be written as a ratio of integers. He proved that root 2 is an irrational number. After this, Theodorus of Cyrene proved that root 3, 5, 6, 7, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 17 all are irrational numbers. The rational and irrational numbers combine to form real numbers which are represented by the symbol R. That is, under real numbers, there are only two types of numbers, rational and irrational. Since all these numbers can be represented on the number line, we call them real numbers, and that number line is called the real number line. That's all in this video. In this session, we learned different types of numbers and learned about rational numbers and irrational numbers. See you in the next video. Thank you.